Today we'll be creating a project inspired by Carly Waito, focusing on color and value. Value is the lightness or darkness of a color. When you add white to a color, it is called a tint. When you add black to a color, it is called a shade. Begin with your paper in a portrait style. Find the middle of your paper by placing your hand in the center. Begin by drawing a short vertical line in the center of your paper, and then adding two diagonals pointing upwards towards the top of your paper, like an arrow. Then you're going to add two more lines to kind of complete that arrow shape that are parallel to the first two. Then top everything off with a triangle shape. Bring down two vertical lines from the points, and you have your first crystal. Next up, you are going to add a diagonal line off to the left with a little bit of a triangle towards the top. Now you're gonna make another angled line that's parallel to your first line and bring that down. Yours might look different than mine, and that is totally fine because we're all doing this on our own. Next up, you wanna add a diamond shape in between the two that's a little bit taller. And then from each point, draw a vertical line down towards the other crystals. Next up, you're going to be adding a pointed upside down triangle with diagonal lines with a triangle on top. And then in between those two, another diamond shape, rough diamond shape, and then vertical lines down once again. Each of our crystals will have multiple facets, and we'll add those in just a minute. Those are different faces for our crystals. Your last crystal shape can look like anything, can be shorter or longer, depending on what kind of shapes you've already drawn. We want a variety of shapes. Now we're gonna add some facets by adding some angled lines, and then using those angled lines as points to draw down towards the bottom. So anywhere where you have a point, you want to add a line. You can add multiple facets to your crystal shapes. Sometimes crystals have little chips in them. We want them to kind of look like a pyramid. So by adding that straight line down, it gives it a pyramid three-dimensional shape. Change it up a little bit, play around with a little bit, see how many different faces you can put on your crystals. And then finally, adding some little fun pieces. I'm adding some little triangles to give it some more dimension and different facets. And you should have six crystals when you're done. The next step is the base of your crystals, where all of your crystals are coming out of. You're going to create bumpy or wavy lines around your crystals to create the base. And I just add some more inside just to show a little bit of depth and give it some three dimensions. So just adding those little lines in there is to guide you when you begin painting. For this project, you want to make sure that you have a variety of tints and shades of every color. So if you're gonna start with red, obviously, because that's the first color in the rainbow, you're gonna wanna grab reds and maroons and pinks and other colors that are similar to red in shade and value. And on your sides that are supposed to be darker, where the light's not hitting it, you're gonna use your darker colors on those sides. So as you can see, I am going on to my next color in the rainbow order, which is orange, and I'm coloring darker on the right side because my light source is coming from the top and the left. So you fill in each shape with each color. Now we're on to green after yellow, and I am, wherever there's a shadow, I make sure that it's darker in that area by coloring a little bit harder too. So I've got my blue up next. And I'm using blue and indigo in the same crystal. So I've got my darker blues on the right side and my lighter blues on the left side, my indigo on the right side. And finally I end up with purple. I fill that all in. Nice. Next up, you're gonna draw the base. And what I used was a black watercolor crayon to trace all the lines that I drew in pencil. And then I'm going back in with a gray and I'm kind of creating a shadow. If you've used watercolor crayons, you're going to color in or paint in one color at a time. Even if they're in the same color family, you want to make sure you're not mixing those colors up because you want to show the value and shade of each color. So you make sure that your brush is wet nicely and you fill in each line. The cool thing about watercolor is, or watercolor pencils or crayons, is that it's not gonna go anywhere that your water doesn't go. So you have to have really good control over where you're placing your brush. You're gonna carefully fill in each color and wash your brush between each and every color so you don't have any color mixing going on. That's not the purpose of this project. Last but not least, you're gonna trace very carefully on top of those lines that you created with the black watercolor crayon. And then once you're done with that, you're gonna kind of blend out that gray that you drew to create that shadow effect. Use the black color to kind of draw it away from the lines that you drew, but you still wanna leave some of those white areas so that you have a little bit of shading and value going on the base, right? Anything that's closer to the base is gonna be a little bit darker just because of the shadows that your crystals are creating underneath it. Continue to work the black paint up and around and make it look just the way that you would like it to look for your project. And I'm done. You should have your rainbow inspired crystals with a variety of tints and shades. Reflection time. What did you find challenging? What would you change? What was your favorite part?